Today I will present to you a paper we studied with Furkan Solmazgül. Furkan, would you like to introduce yourself? Can you hear?
Hi everyone.
Yeah.
I'm also working in a Turkish aerospace in for 4 years with my colleague Haluk, and we prepared this study for this conference. That's all for me.
Thank you, Furkan. If you talk briefly about Turkish aerospace, being among top 100 global players in aviation and space industry, this slide is showing that Turkish fighter program and aircraft groups, structural groups, helicopter groups, UAV groups, space groups, and national combat aircraft groups. Turkish aerospace is organized under 6 strategic business centers. Next slide, contents. The scope of paper, our paper is a little different, computer science or data science. Our paper control and modeling subjects. Today I will present to you our paper, a model-based system engineering approach with SysML for an automatic flight control system. We examine in a detail flight control system by using model-based system engineering approach. I hope that you will enjoy the presentation. We enjoyed making it, so you know. Contents, background, and then design method, which includes model-based system engineering process. And then design, 3 main components, requirements management, system architecture management, model-based system engineering process. And finally, conclusion, future works and mitigation reference, and Q&A. Okay. Firstly, let's look at some system engineering and model-based system engineering definition. The system engineering definition, according to INCOSE reference, is to as follows. System engineering is an interdisciplinary approach and means to enable realization successful systems. In here, important point, interdisciplinary approach. Our view of the definition, system engineering definition is as follows. Systems engineering is a multidisciplinary and common mind approach that ensures successful realization of systems. Keyword is multidisciplinary and common mind. And then the model-based system engineering definition, according to INCOSE reference, in here, model-based system engineering is formalized application of modeling to support system requirements, design, analysis, verification, validation, activities beginning in the conceptual design phase and continuing throughout development later life cycle phases. And then here, important point, all phases in life cycle. In our view, model-based system engineering is an approach to successfully realize system driven by a model, which consists of a set of views that reflect multiple perspectives of the system. The keyword, driven by model, multiple perspective of the system. Traditional system engineering, model-based system engineering. Traditional system engineering has 3 main problems. First, in adequate in defining complex system, like a helicopter or aircraft or vehicle. And then 2, communication between stakeholder. 3, common language interpretation among different design teams. Since system engineering is an interdisciplinary specialism. There are some problems in communication. Yeah. Develop model-based system engineering to find solution to such problems. Main problems. Yeah. Model-based system engineering to find solution. How? It's an advantage automatic generation of most of system documents by using developed models. Second model can be measured. It is easy to control, manage in complex systems. Consistency for all information in system architecture thanks to models. Ensuring traceability in the life cycle with using SysML. Easier to access information. Systematic is apply while model being established. More understandable communication establishment thanks to representation of requirements as a model. Improving communication as a result, establishment of common terminology and concept between all stakeholder and design teams of system. And then design method, developed and used in this study is described in this presentation. Main reference in COSE System Engineering Handbook. By examining this approach, sixth approach, one in COSE object-oriented system engineering method, two IBM Rational Teleological Harmony SA, three process for systems engineering, four VITEC MBSE methodology, five GPS state analysis, six Dory object. We created model-based system engineering design method as shown on the right. Requirements management are and system engineering management are every stage of the design. Model-based system engineering process consists of four main components. First, requirements analysis, system to next step, system function analysis, next step, system architecture design, and finally, detailed system architecture design. Model-based system engineering process with input to output. Input is a customer requirements. Customer requirements, which means requested by customer. With this method, requirements are system architecture, emerge, and in other expression, outputs MBCA, system requirements and architecture. Thus, a roadmap for design engineer and preliminary design are realized. Customer requirements inputs, model-based system engineering process, for component, and then two-stage requirements loop, and then two and three-stage architecture loop, one four-stage verification, and then output system requirements and architecture. In another expression, roadmap of the design engineers. Okay, design. Helicopter automatic flight control system architecture design realized by using SysML, SysML system modeling language, with model-based system engineering approach. Design steps is requirement management, system architecture management, and model-based system engineering process for component. Requirements management is an iterative process that continues throughout model-based system engineering process of the case study. Requirements management covers the following process, four process, definition of requirements, validation of requirements, traceability and verification of requirements, transfer and synchronization of requirements. In the requirements management, managing the requirements with a single software ensures each stage is carried out more efficiently. In the case study, IBM Doors software was selected for requirement management process. IBM Rational Rhapsody is system architecture tools, model elements, system architecture. With modeled CSML was created by using IBM Rational Rhapsody. Requirements management, first process, requirements management, definition of requirements. Definition of requirements, right figures, requirements hierarchy. Requirements hierarchy, the levels at the which requirements are created, which standard are used to as the source when driving the requirements set as shown figure. Within the scope of case study, three set of requirements. One, contractual requirements, two, system requirements, three, software requirements. Contractual requirements that defining behaviors that target to occur in the system and receive it from customer. system requirements that defining all functions, properties of the system. Third, software requirements that taken as reference when designing flight control computer and implementing the software. Sorry. An example of ID, it's a left figure, requirements in. Defining in a doors with attribute columns. An example of ID and attributes defined requirements set in showing. Object type, object type attributes, three attributes includes here. Object type, means of compliance, which means a verification method. And then object reference. Object type refers to type of requirements according to its content, like information, heading, structural or functional requirements. Means of compliance, verification methods, expression which method validate and verification requirements. Example, design review, calculation, analysis, laboratory test, ground test. Object reference refers to source, the created requirements. And then requirements definition is that's all. Requirements management two-stage validation of requirements. It indicates that requirements are complete and correct. Validation process is usually done using checklist of requirements. Requirements are updated by considering the missing and inaccurate statements resulting from checklist and analysis. Some sample question in here is identifiable as a requirement. Is it physically possible to meet requirements? Does the requirements conflict with others? That's a sample question. third phase is traceability and verification of requirements. In the right figure is a requirements hierarchy and a set of requirements is traceability, provide the traceability. Traceability in requirements define whole life process of the requirements. The life process requirements start from where its history and source base continue new requirements that will be created throughout development period. The requirements set with the more general expression is the highest level highest level requirement is the contractual requirement, and lowest level is the software requirements. In the case study, traceability has been provided between the lowest level software requirements and the highest level customer requirements set with the connectors. Traceability of requirements is very important for verifying the requirements. Verification of requirements are defined as demonstrating that the system is designed correctly according to customer requirements as a result implementation of the requirements. The requirement validation process begins after the design and finish check design has been made accordance with the requirements. There are several methods, MOC, example, calculation and analysis. Compliance is proven by an analyzed activity and report, static, fatigue, strength analysis, or offline simulation, modeling analysis, etc. This is a verification method. And then thirdly, requirements management, transfer and synchronization of requirements. By transfer and synchronization between the IBM Gateway tools, Rational Rhapsody models and DORS requirements, which link to is created models of requirements and DORS that manage of the requirements were provided continuous integration between requirements and models. Every stage is updated, and then good communication. System architecture management, second. Yeah, firstly, requirements management, second, system architecture management, third, model-based system engineering process. System engineering management is carried out with SysML, system modeling language. Like Drive UML, you know, computer science, which is a visual graphic based architectural modeling used to system engineering applications. SysML has a grammar and vocabulary, just like any the natural language we speak in the world, example, English, Japanese, etc. models are created to develop system architecture with SysML. SysML models are examined under three main titles: structural, requirement, and behavioral. Various diagrams are used to create SysML model. SysML diagrams, trees in here, structure diagrams, block definition, internal block diagram, and package diagram. Behavioral functional diagrams, activity sequence, state machine, and use case diagrams. The structural expression of model answered the question, what is the system? Structural model are used to define the system, define system component, system features, system constraint. Behavior diagrams, how is the system behaves, define behavior of the system, use case of the system, function of system, activity and sequence of the systems. System architecture management, right figures, a lot of there are a lot of package in the case study. analysis package consists of behavioral models or requirement analysis, including use case diagram, activity diagram, and sequence diagram. Architecture package consists of structural model containing block definition diagram, internal block diagram, and package diagram. Helicopter model library is a library containing model elements, relation, ship, unit, sub-package used to study. The requirements package is the models of the requirements created within the scope of The case study requirements found in the Dorsal Fair. Model-based engineering process has a main four components. One component requirement analysis, two components system function analysis, three components system architecture design, four components detailed system architecture design. Has four stage MBSE has four stage for efficiency design. Model-based system engineering is an approach used to reveal the needs that involve different perspective of stakeholder, which one of the problems system engineering and analyzes the requirements with models and make the more detailed and understandable. Thus, in complex system like helicopter, the entire process from custom requirements to system requirements and system architecture can be explained with this approach. Requirements analysis process is the first phase of the model-based system engineering process. The input of requirements analysis process is the customer requirements. Customer requirements and then output use case models of the system. The requirements analysis process includes the design steps, examining customer requirement and determining required behaviors, derivation of preliminary system requirements for use case determined with reference to customer requirements and standards, and linking drive system requirements of the system requirements to customer requirements. Write a figure, the use case, stabilize helicopter use case, and refine requirements, a lot of refine requirements, and then left figure, use case diagram, example for case study. Automatic flight control systems that includes a lot of use case, for example, stabilized helicopter, attitude hold helicopter, and then give feedback from sensors. That's a lot of use case. okay, system. Functional analysis process is the second phase model-based system engineering process. Functional analysis is defined as a systematic process for defining and associating the functions that the system must perform in order to succeed. The functional analysis process is carried out for following steps to define all functions that system must fulfill to meet the requirements in the graphical model, to allocation of the detailed requirements created as a result of detailing system requirements, defining sub-functions required for each function, explain what to do, how to do it before implementing the requirements. The activity diagram is here, the slides. Activity diagram shows the dynamic aspect of the system and the action-to-action control flow. It defines the basic interaction between systems and environment or interconnection of behavior of the components. And activity diagram allows you to accurately transfer to most complex behavioral goals by creating different scenarios. Various types of actions. In here, stabilize helicopter activity diagram and engage and then stabilize helicopter roll pitch yaw command in here. This is an example. The system architecture design is the third phase of model-based system engineering process. System architecture is defined as the conceptual model that defines structure, behavior, and formality of the system. System architecture design contains defining basic system functions, classification of the functions and creation of functional architecture, creation of structural components from functional architecture, allocation of system levels, creation of structural architecture, and obtaining structural requirements. Figure block definition diagram, stabilized helicopter. It provides a visual presentation to manage architecture system complexity and create communication and coordination mechanism between components. The output system architecture design process is conceptual model that defines structure, behavior, and formality. As a result, creation of block definition diagram is a right figure. The structural architecture and structural requirements of helicopter automatic flight control system were revealed. Then final stage of process model-based system engineering is a detailed system architecture design. The detailing of the system architecture aims to explain in which order structural architecture components the system operate in accordance with scenarios and show communication between components. Firstly, use case diagram in highest level, and then activity diagram, and then sequence diagram. It's derived to diagrams from use case to sequence. The process in here. And then when creating a sequence diagram, a scenario is selected firstly from activity diagram, which means a sequence diagram, scenarios activity diagram, the blocks in which actions that are active in the selected scenario are allocated are added to sequence diagram as lifeline model component. Communication between lifeline model components in here plot and plant. Plant is a helicopter, and there are a lot of lifeline autopilot system, autopilot logic, autopilot law, different switch engage or disengage scenarios in here, for example. Next slide, during the system detailing process, the message transmitted between the blocks, the sequence diagram are examined, the interface of the subsystem are created. This subsystem is here, show figure. Automatic flight control systems has three subsystems, cockpit control, and flight control and sensors. A plant is a helicopter, is real helicopter. The interface are shown internal block diagram in SEMEL. The interface has been defined for all blocks created and in the system. The helicopter and automatic flight control system interface used to be designed shown in the figure. And then finally, conclusion. The model-based system engineering process covers the requirements and system architecture stage of model-based system engineering process. Accordingly, requirement management, system architecture management, and model-based system engineering design process have been developed within the scope of requirements management study. The requirements were defined in the DORS software, and checklist was created, validation of requirements. The requirements was traceable, requirements validation were defined, and transfer methods and different software the linkage. Within the scope of system architecture management study is the model organization for helicopter automatic flight control system was realized IBM Rational Rhapsody software with using the SEMEL. To summarize briefly, with the model-based system engineering approach and application of this study, a solution was found to main problems of traditional system engineering. Model-based systems engineering approach is more systematic than traditional system engineering, but requires more preparation before implementation. As a result, a case study has shown that the more efficient design process for management and traceability. The planet the future works are similar to the work done in article. In the future, it can be applied in all aircraft design process or concept design stage process. Yeah, and then more detailed testing and verification can be done using advanced simulation infrastructure programs. Maybe traceability can be achieved by providing integration between programs where design in different disciplines are realized, system engineering design. That's future plans. Some of the reference we used in this study are follows. And that was our presentation. Finish. Thank you for your listening. Do you have a question?